Zdravstvuyte, Tovarishche, and welcome back to another Worker Wednesday, where we're picking things up right where we left them off and continuing to develop our glorious Soviet Republic. Folks, when I'm not playing this game, I'm thinking about playing this game. It's kind of ridiculous how much this game has grown on me. And as we near 100 episodes, there is still so much work to do and so much to look forward to. Folks, as always, I just want to mention, if you've been enjoying the series and you want to see us hit episode 100 and maybe even 200, 300, I don't know, 1,000, y'all keep letting me know, please, with your likes and comments down below. It makes a massive difference. That's why I keep repeating it like a broken record, because it does change what I do and how I do it on this channel. So folks, keep letting me know. I don't want to belabor you with a long introduction. There is a lot to get done, so let's go ahead and get this party started as I hover over Saint Partia. Oh man, the naming. We actually do have some names to get down soon as well. Chirov over here needs to be developed and renamed. Our, Vira needs a new name as well. Otherwise, I feel like we're pretty well done down over here. Yeah. So just a couple of names. I'm not looking for them just yet, so don't drop them just yet, but just exciting prospects to look forward to. Now, before I hit play, a couple things to do. As always, I like to review. Our money's looking good. Our money's looking real nice, some might say. Our economy is looking pretty solid as well. Our imports we're going to continue to work on reducing whenever possible. But one thing was pointed out to me, actually on an older episode, a comment was dropped with regards to the shift in price of steel versus mechanical components. So if we sell steel, it's 15.16, and if we sell mechanical components, it's 25.17. So what is the ratio of steel to mechanical components? Because if it's 2-to-1, so I just want to make sure Audible was off. If it is 2-to-1, mechanical components, where are you? There you are. It's not. It's like 1.5. No. Yeah, it's like 1.5, right? Because if 22 tons of steel becomes 15 tons of mechanical components, 15 plus 7 is 23, right? No, 22. Oh yeah, it is 1.5. It's exactly 1.5. Wow, that was the slowest math I've ever done in my life. So 1.5 times 15. Okay, so we're still fine then. Maybe at some point the numbers had changed, because again, this was from an old episode, but it was just brought up, so I wanted to check if it was still the case, because price fluctuations are in the game. If we look at the year, you can see there are some fluctuations, and oh, hey, would you look at that? I wish I could see the key. I can't actually see the legend here. That's annoying. Like, what are the two blues? Light blue and dark blue, because those prices have seriously changed. Those must be dollars buy and sell, just based on looking at the numbers. So the two blues, that makes sense as well. The two reds would be the rubles, and the two blues would be, you know, NATO money. That makes sense. Wow, that's a huge flux. What else have we got going on over here? I mean, it's cool to see the graphs, and this is just this year. I mean, last year, I'm sure we saw, oh yeah, look at that. Oh, that's wild. I like rarely notice it, but you know, looking at it represented like this, you can really see. Wow. That's madness. All right, cool. We should pay more attention to that stuff. It's a very interesting feature in the game. I would like to pay more attention to it. Apart from that, reviewing our economy, I do like to look at our population as well. 21K. This situation is a problem, and this is something we're going to have to solve quickly. It was brought up in the comments, and I do agree. I mean, I was hoping that Uprising Grad would be enough to, you know, kick us off in terms of moving adults living with their parents down over here, but we might need to extend Uprising Grad sooner rather than later, build the residential areas down over here, commission all of this construction as well, some resources. No one's been assigned yet. I need to start building all these things up, because really, we don't have time. 600, right? 600 people. This can fit 300. This can fit 400. So we have 1, 2. How many can this one fit? No, it's bigger than this one, right? It's not the same. Well, let's say 300, right? That's 600. That's 900 plus another 100 or so. 1,000. Yeah, we need to get these built quickly, and then we need to work on the southern extension there. But sorry, that's after I hit play. I'm gonna figure that out. One thing I want to do up over here before we hit play is sort this out. We've been getting jams here very often, and I think, well, not I think, but I'm fairly certain that the reason for that is because we have this single track. And while that was working nicely for a while, we're past that phase because of how many trains are coming up over here and the way trains are flowing through. Now, the problem is that we have this conveyor belt with its legs down there blocking the way. What I'm hoping is if we make this a proper block with two tracks, and we have an in and an out, and we maybe have a crossing as well, then maybe, well, we have the crossing up there. I wonder if we should have a crossing in here instead or as well. But then maybe we'll have cleaner movement. Something to think about. Well, not something to think about, but something to act on, I think. The thing is, in my mods, I do have a, now is it under, where is... I've got the conveyor, not three rail, road and rail crossing. There we go, two track. I've got this. Now, the thing is, no, I don't need the one with the roads as well. One track. Where is my, nope. I mean, I really love these mods. I mean, I guess I could put this one down over here and use the road connection as well. Point being, if we can drop this over here, we might need to adjust some of the wiring and things like that. But if we can put this down over here, it would have to be the other way around, right? Because this is going down this way. It'd have to be like this. So we need the reverse road and two rails reverse. There we go. Sorry, this is what we need. And then that'll bring the iron down and over, and hopefully it'll solve the problem over here. Man, I love that the modding scene is already so active. And the reason why I want to do this while paused is, of course, because this will, you know, slow things down. It'll hurt our tracks and all that stuff as well. So let's go ahead and do this and get rid of you as well, right? It's painful to see, but important. I wonder if I want to keep these as crossings. And of course, I'll be paying for all this, folks. I'm not gonna wait for our tracks to be built or anything like that. Go ahead and demolish you as well, and over here too, please. There we go. All right. So there we go. The reverse is what we're gonna put down, and hopefully it'll work smoothly here. Seeing something of a connection here, so that's a start, right? We can do that. All right. Well, hello. Excuse me. Did you build? Can't tell if it's down or not. I don't see it. Oh, you know what? Wow, was I just blinded by the by the fact that it was making connections? I didn't even notice that that it didn't actually work. I think so. My apologies, folks. All right, here we go. Here we go. Looking close. We can do this kind of a thing. That's pretty good, I would say. Not my favorite with the conveyor belt on the side there, but it'll do the trick. So we connect you over here. There we go. Okay. And then the tracks. We are not in auto build. Okay, good. Let's go ahead and get you too sharp of a turn. That's fine. That's fine. Just got to cancel a little bit further back. Right. And I think we'll be fine. I think we'll be fine if I do this kind of a thing. And then this kind of a thing overlaps with existing construction. That's just, what are you, what? Game. All right, let's pull further back. Again, we've got so much money that I'm not too concerned about the cost of this. There we go. I'm more concerned about the efficiency of it. I really hope this works. I really need it to work. There we go. Is it the smoothest? Is it the cleanest? You know, it's actually not that bad. I thought it was going to be a lot worse. I'm going to be honest with you. In full transparency, I thought it was going to be hideous. And I was really worried about this execution. But this is pretty good. Okay, this is pretty good. And let's go ahead and get our high voltage wire connection over here. Which one are you again? You're this one, aren't you? Yes, you are. We got to connect you to there. Buildings in the way. Let's go ahead up this way. Might have to go up and around. Or we pull even further back. Because we've got you over here. Gonna get pricey, but it's fine. This one? Yeah. Building in the way. I thought I saw a spot over here. There is one, but I don't know if it'll be able to pull further along. Oh yeah, there we go. Beautiful. Beautiful's a strong word. Beautiful's a very strong word. But we can pull over to here. and connect. Yeah, cool. That's fine. I'm okay with that. So we'll pay for that with rubles, of course, right? We're gonna go ahead and pay for all this with rubles. Oh man, I'm so glad that this is done. But now's the moment of truth, though. Will this actually solve the problem? That's the real question. Get all this done. I should commission the tracks as well. So let's go ahead and commission you. And let's go ahead and pay for you, and also you. Now, before I forget, because this did remind me, as did the comments. Again, this is a result of the comments. It was pointed out that over here, we need to get this thing built so our machines can continue building the tracks over here. So let's go ahead and make sure that gets done ASAP as well. Let's go ahead and assign you. Everything needs to be built. There's no time to waste. Everything needs to be built. We got to bring people down here so that those people can work on the construction sites, and as they work on the construction sites, they'll be able to build up the places where they're actually going to be working. It's going to be an interesting chain of things to get done. All right, hopefully that does the trick. We've got another large construction office back over here that should be working on these things. Again, if they're doing nothing but bringing materials, even that's something. Materials and workers. All right, so that's all good up over here. Let me just double check. I've got you commissioned. Yes, so let's go ahead and hit play. The question is always this. Do I need semaphores? Do I need a crossing? We've got one up there, right? So if something comes up here, should it be able to choose the track it goes in on? I think yes. Makes sense to me, right? Now we could have it make that choice over here, or even further back. If we do it over here, crossing not allowed. Okay, there we go. I'm trying to figure out the ups and downs, right? Because we've got the crossing over here, but then it's attached to one side or the other down over here. I'm almost tempted to get rid of the crossing over here and just put one over here. Let's experiment, right? Let's experiment. We've got money to experiment with, so let's do it. Okay, there we go. Got our ins. You're coming in one way, and then this becomes a two-way. I think that's right. We'll find out. Make sure you get built. Let's make sure you get built. Cool. All right, time to hit play and see our problems go away? Question mark. All right, good stuff. Power is flowing. This thing is still being built, and then it'll quickly start bringing iron back down again. Now, why is there? Okay, good. We're done. All right, because this was still being built. Yep, looks like iron is still flowing. Connections are still made. We've got our track upgraded again. Wouldn't be possible without the mods, and that's to me, especially ever since Cities Skylines, right? Mods define the longevity of a city builder. And to see these kinds of mods and bigger mods, there's a tech tree mod that I noticed the other day. I haven't tried it out yet, but the fact that it exists and people are thinking about it, absolutely huge. So it just gets me all sorts of excited. Now, actually, clicking on that little tram there reminds me, many of y'all were suggesting that instead of bringing people up here via bus to help, you know, with the processing of the stone, I should get people over from the train over here, from the stop over here. Yeah, it'd be faster. My concern is, right now, the tram comes through, it's 150 workers, we need 15 plus 15, so that's 45, and however many are left over to come down here, that's 250. I guess I could reduce how much mining and stuff we're doing down over here, and instead have some people driven up to this bus stop. That is an option. It's nearby. It would be relatively efficient. We could shut down another one of the processing plants, I suppose. I suppose that is an option. Workers here. I just worry about having to import more iron, you know, because we're presently backed up over here. That's not a permanent state of existence. Right, like that could go away real quick. It's not a bad idea though. I'm not shooing the idea off or anything. Though if we look, we can see that we're not doing too shabbily over here in terms of actually having workers come here in time, I think. We'll let it be for now. Let's see how this current solution works, and then we'll further experiment with it if necessary. Gravel, maybe we just have to import it, folks. Still a few too many trucks coming in over here. I wonder if I shouldn't reassign some of these. Quarry 6, which one is Quarry 6? All the way over here. Oh, no, that one's close. I don't want to reassign any of the ones that are, like, you know, from the nearby ones. Gravel Quarry is almost certainly the one that's, like, right next to us, right? Yeah. Let's see, Gravel Quarry. Gravel Quarry. Oh, they're both just called Gravel Quarry. Are you serious? Come on. Well, if it's got Party Power in its name, I guess I should ignore it, though these are also... Okay, Quarry 5. This is the easiest way to do it. Rostinsky Gravel Processing Plant. Yep. Rostinsky. So you're all going to the Rostinsky area. Good. Up over here as well, I believe we did a similar change to make sure these were all going to Rostinsky. No, you're going to Party Power. Let's see. They are all going to Party Power. All right, cool. Let's reassign these guys as well. And that should help with the clogging, I think. I hope. Now let's go ahead and add you. There you will unload, please. There we go. And I would like to copy that schedule. Let's see if I can find you. I want to copy that schedule over to you. Done. And I want to copy that schedule over to you. Done. Okay, awesome. Cool. That was a relatively efficient way to do that. Good stuff. They're all going to this one. We'll see if it starts clogging up. These guys are coming down with stone. It's so cool. I guess it's one from each, I suspect. Well, that's cool. It is interesting to see the limitations of this. Now, some of y'all have pointed out that there is a mod that allows you to bring stone in with a... conveyor belt, so I might actually get that mod and get a third one up there or replace one of these, but I just wanted to see if this experiment of ours, you know, would work before we just abandoned it. I like testing out the limitations of the game before diving into mods constantly. Just, I don't know, maybe that's a me problem, I suppose. No blockages here yet. All right, we're good. We'll come back to review that soon, but for now at least we're good. Down over here, let's go ahead and I'm tempted to just double speed it. Because I think we're fine to double speed. Though I do want to build some of these roads up. Auto build roads with the lights, of course. These are main roads. Get you done. We'll just pay for these, right? We don't have to, again, belabor this solution or issue or whatever you want to call it. That's why we make money, right? We make money to spend money. Go ahead and get this connection done as well. Evidently, it's a bunch of connections. There we go. Nice and easy. Beautiful. Makes the city look nicer as well, right? That's so exciting. Uprising Grad is like mostly our own resources and everything. It's pretty wild. This game is wild. All right, there we go. Finish your connection as well. Good stuff. And I think it's time, actually, to also put down some more trees. Not just here, but elsewhere as well. We'll want to upgrade the footpaths as well before I forget. And before they get hidden by these trees. Because God knows that's going to happen. Make this connection. Can we make a connection down here as well? No, too steep of a descent. Unless we connect there. All right, cool. Let's do it. This looks right. Connect you. There we go. Good stuff. Done. We got this road piece over here that's looking hideous. Fix that. I need to make sure I turn auto build off before I spend a bunch of money on something useless. We'll upgrade this when these buildings are all done, of course. waiting on that. And then there's a footpath up over here that needs paying for. Cool. All right, turn auto build off again before we make a huge mistake. The roads, I love this central road. Even though the AI doesn't always listen to one ways in the central tram or whatever, or trolley bus, it still looks cool. Looks dope. I got workers coming through over here, right? You were empty, weren't you? Progress is being made still, so that's good. Oh, good, good, good. 45 workers being brought down. Where did you drop people off? Oh, this is a weird... Uprising grad trolley bus stop. Going there to pick workers up. Oh, this is its new directions. Lots of workers waiting up over here. It's not bad. I want that to happen. Food is still a problem down here. Now, we did try to fix that at the end of last session. One thing I need to do actually on the topic of food. Let's go ahead and double speed it because we can start solving some of these problems in double speed. So crops. We don't have that much wastage going on over here. It was pointed out that I should take a look at maybe getting a distribution office down here to help organize the movement of crops, but it doesn't look so messy or busy, so I don't think that's necessary. I think we've got a good efficient number going on over here. Though this 800 tons needs to be shipped a little bit faster, I think. We're not doing too poorly. 60 tons in here right now. You are here to pick up livestock. All right. Not doing too poorly at all. What's the deal up over here, though? Food is... Got workers. No crops, though. No crops up here. Where is my crop train? There it is. Right? Yep. You need to pick up more than 60 tons is the thing. Need to pick up more than 60 tons. I wonder if we should... You know what? Wait until loaded. No, that's going to take forever. For 108 tons of crops, it'll take forever. We could try... We could wait for a little bit more. Maybe let's wait for, like, 80 tons. Potentially. Right? Like, maybe that's good enough. Maybe even 90 tons. Actually, we're almost at 108. Let's make it a full load. Let's make it a full load. And that way, we'll hopefully have some sustainability. Because that's just it. We need to get the gears rolling. We need to get that momentum that we had at one point. So, you know... It's a month of low food supplies for an eternity of happiness and joy. It's a silver lining way of looking at it, I suppose. Okay, let's see. One more shipment ought to do it, right? I'm going to go ahead and say that that's good enough. No longer waiting until loaded. Now the next couple of trucks will hopefully fill you right up. I mean, geez, do I... The other option is to buy more trucks and get this happening with more trucks. And it might be necessary, actually. Because if the ship keeps coming in with more crops, you're about to load up some more, right? Because you're headed to the harbor. Question becomes, does the harbor have enough access to crops? Another 144 tons. So you know what, actually? It might not be a bad investment. It might not be a bad investment. Let's go ahead and do it. And the reason why I'm not doing a distribution office is because this is a relatively simple area, I suppose. So we don't have to overdo it. Covered hull. The KMZ 5410 is still my top pick. Is there a replacement? I don't think so. I don't think so. What's going to beat that 12 tons? What's going to beat that 12 tons? Nothing. Nothing. Go ahead and get two of them. Perhaps. You're doing the right thing, right? Yep. Pop these down over here, and let's get them started right away. No need to delay them or anything. It's a cargo station, so that should be okay, and hopefully it'll bring crops in just that a little bit faster. Just that little bit faster that we need. At least meat's being produced endlessly. Yeah, this is good. More crops are being brought through. See, the problem is when the crops arrive, the first place they go is up over here. Problem, I say. Because now it's gone. Now these crops are going to get emptied out very quickly. It's definitely an interesting situation. It's crazy how I guess it must have been a month of traffic jamming has cascaded brutally out of control. Well, this isn't too shabby. Right, you're back down here to pick up, what, another 60 or so tons? No, less. 50 tons. It's okay. Food is... We didn't stop, though. We didn't stop here. That's good. And there is a vehicle that brings crops from this grain storage down here as well. That wasn't too bad. We have stopped for a little bit, but we're maybe closing the gap. I wonder if I should get a faster locomotive for this one. Let's see what top speed it hits. Let's see if it hits its top speed. Actually, you know what? I don't even know if I can check its top speed, because if I go to the depot and I go to buy with rubles, the electric locomotive, so 150, so it's hitting its top speed. One can assume. We can get another 10 kilometers per hour with this, but I don't know if that's worth it. I don't think that's worth it. All right, we're fine down there. Let's go ahead and check over here if we've got some jamming going on. Looks like we're in the clear, which is always nice to see. Right, no problems over here. We're dropping some boards and stuff off. Yep. What are you doing? You're headed to the customs house. Okay, good. Very beautiful. Okay, great. Now the question is down over here. Do we have a gravel issue? If we do, do we start buying gravel? We do have a gravel issue. We start buying gravel. That's the answer. Does it suck? Yes, it does. Do we have to do it? Yes, we do. Because otherwise all the construction stops. Now, on the topic of construction stopping, hello. This is another problem area that I'll want to solve sooner rather than later. And is it because you're not making it all the way through? I think so. Let's see. If I do that. There we go. All right. That might be the solution. Literally like millimeters on a semaphore. But hey, if it solves a problem, it solves a problem. And I'm not going to complain about that. Look at all these vehicles trying to get some construction done. All these people trying to drop passengers off. You take your eye off the ball for a second and the ball hits you in the face, right? It's like playing dodgeball as opposed to, I don't know. It's a game where a ball is unlikely to hit you in the face. Can't think of one right now. Alright, well, nonetheless. Balls hitting faces aside, we're moving smoothly again, it seems. Lots of stuff being picked up for the construction sites. This is almost done, which is great because a 700. See how quickly people are growing up? And unemployment right now is through the roof. Holy 1200. How did that suddenly blow up in my face? I mean, we haven't been doing construction up here for a while. I mean, there's a little bit of construction going on, sure, but I don't think that's the issue. It's gotta be down south, how there's a bunch of people now coming to this stop and not being taken anywhere where they're needed, I guess. Hey, that's pretty cool. The train platform's almost done. Didn't pay for it or anything. Got rushed pretty quickly, I would say. Nice, and there you have it. It's done. Very cool. Actually, on the topic of train, what is the deal with our... This is dope. Tunnel's almost done. And it is a big tunnel. That sense of accomplishment, honestly. Alright, lots of prefab panels and stuff being brought down. Yes, good. Good stuff. Lots of prefab panels needed over here. This construction, I think, needs a lot of stuff. Yeah. It's good to finally be using some of the stuff up, though. And I do need to plan the extension, like I was saying, right? We need the extension of the city. Got a university over here. We've got hospitals, fire station. All this stuff is fine. I think we just need a residential extension. Before I do that, though, one thing I've slipped my mind earlier is I should get more trees planted in this general area where our trees are being cut down for wood. Gotta be sustainable, right? Gotta be sustainable. What's the deal up over here? Let's get some more down. Yep, good stuff. Always use more trees in this area, especially for the pollution. You guys are flowing smoothly, it looks like, so that's comfortable. Slash comforting, whichever word you want to use. I'll use both. Go ahead and put some trees down up over here as well. There we go. It's nice to have a little bit of greenery, right? Regardless of pollution or not, it's nice to have a little bit of greenery. Hey, would you look at that? We've got a gravel store. We've actually got stock of gravel. That's got to be because something's backed up, right? The concrete plant has too much gravel. Not enough workers coming through, I guess, to... Oh, right. It's not been exporting concrete. So that's good. Down over here, we're backed up. this is good, right? It's, I say backed up. Backed up is typically associated as a negative, with a negative connotation, but this is a good type of backed up because that means we have a great surplus. We've picked up 120 tons of gravel over here for the first time in a long time. Oh man, I'm so happy. Oh, that's so dope. That's so dope. Now, what's happening over here? Are you picking up prefab panels? You are. All right, good. All these little buddies going around. They remind me of Wally. And you know who Wally reminds me of? Short Circuit, Johnny Five. If you don't know what I'm talking about, look it up. Wally's design is just stolen off of Johnny Five. I'll fight you on that. God. And if you do know what I'm, if you do know the Short Circuit movie, please let me know. I find it so hard to find other people who know about the Short Circuit movies. The wonderful pair of films from what, the 80s, 90s? I can't even remember now. Anyways, I digress. It's 87. Oh man, we're coming on my birthday. Now here we're seeing a lack of traffic, eh? What's the deal? Got some workers waiting. Is it because all the workers are going to the construction sites? Maybe. Maybe. Okay, gravel's backing up over here. Like, it's getting pretty topped up here, too. That's cool. Well, let's take a look at cement. Right, because we've got gravel, we've got workers, missing coal. Do we want to produce coal over here? Let's see. Okay, hold on. Okay. Time for a little bit of math. Various industry? No. Gravel, coal, iron, I think. Cement. Or... right, cement. So cement takes 22 tons of coal to produce 81 tons of cement. So the ratio is a 4-to-1, approximately, right? Approximately 4-to-1. If we are importing cement, hold on. Let me double check this. Sun's about to, well, you know what? We'll wait until the sun sets and then we'll look at that. Let's do light time stuff while the sun's up. How are we going to expand our uprising grad? The parking lots over here. We got a pair of parking lots, which is good. This... God damn, of course the sun would set right now. All right, where were we? So, we're looking at... we're looking at... 1 ton of coal produces... approximately, right? 1 ton of coal produces 4 tons of cement. 1 ton coal, 4 tons cement. 1 ton of coal is 90. 4 tons of cement is 400, 520, 530. So I am better off buying a ton of coal to produce 4 tons of cement. Is that the ratio? Hang on a second. Am I? That doesn't make sense. Doesn't make sense? Yeah. 1 ton of coal plus the 210 tons of gravel, sure. Yeah, we should stop importing cement. We should produce our own cement. Import coal instead. Fair enough. Let's go ahead and buy... if I've done the math wrong and you've noticed I've done the math wrong, please let me know. But I'm pretty sure it's cheaper for me to just import coal and produce the cement. Which makes sense because cement is a processed good, whereas coal is less processed. It's not coal ore. So that makes perfect sense. The reasoning for the math makes sense. We can stop importing cement. Start producing it down over here. We have you with forklifts. Loading cement at the cement silo, dropping it off at the concrete plant. We've got 4 forklifts. So why aren't you actually doing the work? Cement's been backed up. Okay. Good, I guess. Question mark. Where are my forklifts, though? Waiting for Zavod's forklift garage, too. All right. Let's see. Yeah, you're going to the cement silo. Oh, wait. Hold on a second. You are taking cement from the silo. All right, you know, let's reassign this. I want you to pick up cement there and unload cement there. There we go. Okay, I had it backwards, I think. All right, cool. This is good. In fact, if we take a look at our economy, last month. The import of cement cost us... Well, hold on. This month is fine to check. As well. 5k, 6k. It's hard to keep it. It's hard to compare because coal is being imported in a couple of spots. But I do think this is the right way to go about it. And now again, we're becoming a bit more self-sustaining. Coal eventually will be bringing up from V-Raw, right? Of course, we've got so much coal ready to be produced down over here. So as soon as some of these coal mines get done, actually, one's done, we'll have to just build up the conveyor belt connections. Oh my God, V-Raw is actually happening, folks. It's becoming a thing. All right, before I plan further, we do need to get workers, adults living with their parents. I feel like just kind of draining this area a little bit over here. Let's go. The reason why I feel like draining a specific area is because people will move naturally when they are within walking distance of an empty living spot. So I feel like if we, you know, like this is a very congested area as far as adults living with their parents. If we dump a bunch of them down over here and leave some empty slots as well, then people will redistribute a little bit, at least. You can see how quickly that fills right back up, though. Wild. Absolutely wild. Let's go ahead and pick up, from over here. And hopefully as the same problems develop down over here, they'll... You know, these construction sites will be completed and people will be able to move around. A lot of construction going on. A lot of prefab panels needed. Let's make sure that the prefab panels are flowing. It seems as though our train solution up here has worked. Yep. I was just worried that we were seeing a jam, but it looks like it's worked. That makes me so happy. That does make me very happy. And gravel seems to be flowing as well, relatively consistently. Let's check. Okay, we're okay. We're okay, I would say. We just drained some with our train that was up there, right? Sorry, 21 pluses. Still 545. My God. Move out. Take a car. Yeah, let's do that. How many spots we got left? 100 spots left, approximately. That's like barely putting a dent in. Empty you out. 10 citizens. Let's pull some more down. Let's do that. A couple empty slots. Again, people will redistribute themselves. Pull some out of here, sure. Pretty soon this building's gonna get filled up. There we go. Wow, it is filled up. Oh my God. Wild. What about you? You are almost filled up. Do we have doctors working? We do. Okay. I wonder if we actually reduce the number of workers required here. Just because we have so many people coming here, we could do with more professors teaching, for example. Don't even need that many firefighters, if I'm honest. Just to redistribute the... I've been pronouncing that word wrong. It's frustrating me. Just to redistribute... Just to change, it's one of those days, just to change how workers move between different workspaces, right? Okay, so 8 more spots over there. Let's go ahead and take a quick peek over here. 21 pluses, like again, they should be moving themselves around a little bit, but so quickly that it's already topped up. 400 or so. So massive drop very quickly, but... I do hope some of this construction gets done quicker. What I could do is I could build another construction site down over here. Steel, bricks, boards are all kind of backed up. Are you working on stuff even? You are. A lot of trucks here not moving any goods. Do we have prefab panels down here? We do not. Are we bringing prefab panels down here? Hold on a second. Because we should be. We got none up here. We don't have a jam here, do we? We do not. Hang on then, where's my... You're bringing just gravel. Right. What's the deal with prefab panels? You there. Hold on. Nah. Damn it. Just too slow. Only bringing out 20 tons, that's really not ideal. The problem is that... Oh no, we've got 93 tons over here. Gotta move things a bit more efficiently. Gotta get prefab panels down there, because that's gonna be the big slowdown for building houses. They always need prefab panels. Wow, this grain storage has been emptied out. Oh my god, and we have no, like, surplus over here. Is food seriously gonna be a problem again? No. We're looking okay, right? Where are my crops? You're coming through to pick up? Okay, good. There's another 300 tons over here. This is feeling good then. We've got like a smooth flow up over there. All right, cool. Shall we? Or is there something else to distract me? The sun is setting. I'd like to do the planning with a smooth flow. So let me just wait until the sun rises again. Workers are coming through. Construction here is progressing. Quite quickly, actually, if I'm completely honest. Like, there is another phase left, sure, but we are seeing progress here. This coal depot is done as well. If we can get some of these processing plants done too, then we're going to be able to actually activate V-Raw much sooner than I honestly anticipated. I'd love to have at least a V-Raw done before episode 100, and then maybe Pardubice, I'm not sure. Soon after that, pretty soon we'll be making our own cars. Pretty soon. 434, Jesus. See, another construction site down here is not going to make a difference. Or another construction office down here is not going to make a difference. Prefab panels are going to make a difference. Got to keep bringing those prefab panels down. Where's my train with said prefab panels? You still en route? Or do they all get scooped up? They might have all got scooped up. Yeah, definitely, because it's already back up here. Wow, it's crazy how much faster double speed is to single. Money's looking fantastic as well, which means these trains have not been getting blocked up. Let me check real quick. Food, yep, more than enough over here. No food over here, that's a problem. Why do we not have food over here? Where's the vehicle that should be... Oh, there we go. Why did that not get delivered? Clothes, you're bringing food. You're loading food to go to a shopping center, okay. So you'll pull food if you need to, because... Oh, I guess the warehouse does not have enough stock to pull. Okay, well, it's starting to get solved, this problem. More than enough food over here at the shopping center, that's good. Here we saw that there is food, yeah. Okay, and then what about up over here? There's enough alcohol. But I'm looking for food. Sorry, this is the store. Yeah, you're topped up. These guys are good, so that's good. Got everything they need. Wonderful, wonderful. What about down over here? Let's do a quick check. Because hopefully we're fine here. Yeah, plenty of food. Good stuff. And then this was the other problem spot, right? No food yet. No food yet. Okay. This is a problem. Go to this barn first. This barn is almost topped up. Look at this cargo station. This cargo station hopefully still has access to food from this warehouse. No, it does not. Why not? Well, because it's not being pulled, I assume. Because we have a store of food. It's strange. Need to keep an eye on this. Need to keep an eye on this for sure. Crops are being used. Food is being... Oh yeah, okay, so there is a transition happening. Okay, good. I was like, crops are being used, but food is maxed out. Well, it's because the surplus is being pushed into the warehouse. All right, cool. Cool. The alcohol is backed up, though. I wonder if we should export some of that. I do wonder if we should export some of that. We're good here. Cement and gravel completely backed up. So glad I've got that going, because now coal is not being purchased, and neither is cement. We've, you know, saved ourselves a lot of money. That's definitely part of what solved our economy situation, right? All these vehicles down here loading up. Good stuff. This roundabout's worked well for us. And construction here is continuing. I don't remember seeing all these little icons before. Oh, they're here now. Were they there all along? I don't remember. Oh, is it because I commissioned the tracks up there? Maybe? I can't remember. Anyway, relevant. Sun is claiming to set, but it'll be some time yet. Let's go ahead and put some buildings down at the very least. Otherwise, we're never going to get this done. Residential is what I'm looking for here. And I'm looking for the biggest buildings I can put down. 368, 552 workers. Oh, you know what? Are these the 500 workers? Because that'll be great. Maybe. Oh god, the sun. You know what? Yeah, these look like the 500. Okay, thank god. Alright, that's good at least. Because then we've got 1,000, 1,500 workers able to live in these three buildings. So we just got to get those done. 1,500 workers. Cool. That I can work with. Wonder if... Nah, it's the prefab panel slowing us down, right? I don't want to rush any one of these because we've got, we've made so much progress on our own. It seems kind of foolish to abandon that, sense of pride this late. You just need concrete. So we've got concrete coming through. That's good. Workers are here. Steel is maxed out. It's all good. In fact, work is progressing. Like, even as the concrete's being delivered, the rest is still, like, other stuff is being done as well. How are we doing over here? We have assignments, so that's good. These are both done, right? Cool. I wonder if I should get some, like, garages and stuff over here. Obviously, some people are coming in via public transport. But I wonder if I should have checked to make sure that I could get parking lots down over here. I'm pretty sure some will fit. Almost certainly. Like, we saw there's a spot over here. Yeah. So we can probably fit, like, a bunch down in this area and connect it to the roads over here. That's just a depot, though. Could fit one over here. Can fit two over here, actually. And that would allow people that want to supply work, or that want to work at the coal mine and this processing plant. We can get some parking lots down over here as well, potentially. Maybe some smaller ones. And again, there's also always the option of the modded ones, right? That give us more spots. More parking spots. It's not a bad idea. Alright. Back up over here. So, we've got our giant 500-person houses. So why wouldn't we? We need to consider schooling and stuff as well for these guys, right? Like, I wonder if the schools and kindergartens should be up over here and the residential stuff should be back over here. Yeah, let's do that. So, school first. Well, kindergarten first. We've got the massive one available. Right, and that's this one up over here. Which is for over 300 students, or 300 babies, I guess. Go ahead and put you down over here off the main road. You don't need a main road connection. I would say. Let's put you down over here. Oh, come on. Need it to be a bit more perfect than that. There we go. I don't know if that's better. I'm gonna tell myself it is, because otherwise I'll never put this building down. So you drop you down over there. Kids back here will have a clearer view of what matters most. And then let's go ahead and get our big school, which is this one. And this school is the same as the one up over here, right? Which is not 35 students, definitely more than that. Not enough staff or teachers to give us the max number, though. Hold on a second. Doesn't it just tell me when I hover over it? It does not. Unless I check auto build. Still doesn't tell me. All right, great. Useful. Nonetheless, we can put you down over here. got a connection to the road up top there. And what we can do is we can build a main road connection for this. We can also build a connection down this way, right? And then this can connect up to that. Okay, great. That's good. I like that. You know what? Let's go ahead and actually put it down. We'll do this. You'll connect. And you'll connect as well. And that way, we'll have this connect this way, and then the residential buildings over here will have an easy connection to it. Let's go ahead and get our road planned. No, let's get our buildings planned. Again, we're going big. Go big or go home, right? / go big with your home. Let's see. Pop them down like this. Do them like this. Ah, it's so dark. Might be able to stack them. The stackability is very important. Looks like these construction vehicles are... I mean, it's fine. If they want to bring stuff down here, it's fine, because they can't bring stuff up here anymore. All I need up here are prefab panels. So if they want to bring concrete and stuff down here, I'm not going to stop them. Though really, if I'm trying to plan, I should suspend this construction. I don't think I'll be moving this, though. I'll be honest with myself. I don't think I'll be moving either of these two. Busy worker bees here, just chipping away. Alright, sun's back up. No time to waste. Let's go ahead back to massive housing. Right, so one thought was up over here. That's as high as it'll go. Okay, that's not a problem. Go ahead and do that. Suspend your construction, please. Because this I need to plan properly first. We got one up there. We could do parking over here, I suppose. Right, this could be a parking complex. Let's go ahead and get another one of you down over here, or... Put one down over here. Yeah, let's put one down over here. And can I put another one down over here? I can. It'll fit. Will the roads fit after? I think so. I think that should be fine. In fact, let's go ahead and check. One road down there. I don't know if that's actually connecting. That's actually going over top. That's a weird issue. Yeah, let's cancel this road. Let's do this connection first. Let's see if... Oh yeah, there we go. Okay, cool. Very strange, but I'll take it. So we're good there. Can we connect you? Too sharp of a turn. If I pull you back a little bit. There we go. Beautiful. Again, strong word, but... Go ahead and suspend all of your constructions as well, please. Then we can connect you over this way. A little too high. Alright. Next step over. Beautiful. Connect you like so. We can connect you as well. Again, another road connection wouldn't kill us. And our footpath connections... We got you coming through. Of course, you can't just connect directly. That would make my life too easy. Cancel that. Go ahead and connect this head on. No, you won't connect head on either. There we go. Fair enough, I'll accept that. And people over here are able to walk over and up. Right, yeah, there we go, excellent. And people here are able to walk down and over and up, and they should be able to get to the schools. All right, cool. That's another 1,500 people right there. That's got to be sustainable for a little while, right? What I do need, though, what's unsustainable, are my parking garages, my parking lots. Parking lot. Got 32 larges. Perpendicular parking. Nah, let's go with the 32 large, I think. Underground parking. Sorry, how much do they fill again? How much they fit, rather. This one here fits 32, I think. Okay. 2, 4 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, geez. Keeping... Wow. That's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12, 13. 13 times 4 is 40, 52... 53, 54, 54 cars. Is that right? Didn't it used to tell you how many cars it would fit? Oh, these ones say 32. This one does not. Okay. Pretty sure that's the one I'm looking at. Yeah. Well, if it's bigger, or if I think it's bigger, that's good enough for me. Put you down over here. But again, it's still not big enough, right? How many do we need? If I go ahead and extend the road in this direction, that's what we'll do. We'll extend the road in this direction, have a main road connection. The vehicles would have to go up to here to U-turn. That's not too far though, right? I wonder if I get rid of the sidewalk connection over here. Like what I would do is I would get rid of the sidewalk over here. Let the sun come back up first. While we're waiting for the sun though, let's do a quick check. Flip around a little bit. Props are emptied out over here because they're also empty out over here. But that's because they are empty out over here because they are filled up over here. And ooh, food is... Huh. It's weird to think we might have to look at crops again. Very weird to think. But later. For now, back over here. What I was thinking was we would get rid of the footpath here. How can you not? There we go. So get rid of the footpath over here. That would allow me to build a road connection instead. Right? That would go from like up here down. Wherever we can fit it. We do that. And then the footpaths would be like so. This connection is still there. Maybe we can do that. And that. Well, the footpath doesn't go all the way to there, but it's, you know, they can get there if they need to. I think it looks a bit cleaner. And then if we look at the parking garages, we can drop them down over here. We can do like one, two, three, right? Hopefully these guys can all, yeah, walk to each of these. So that's good. Make sure we're suspending their construction, please, and thank you. And then what we can do is we can flip them around and build another set. Because if each one is 52, if that was the count, if my count was right, it could be wrong, right? If my count was right, then 1, 2, 3, that's 156. Another 3, still not. It's a lot of spots. We're really preparing for the vehicle revolution. Gotta nudge over a bit, sure. Yeah, I don't mind that. I don't mind that. Let's get our footpath down this way. Or rather, first, let's go ahead and get our road down this way. It'll probably connect straight down there. Or to make it look a bit more organic, we could do this kind of a thing, right? This kind of a thing. There we go. Yeah, see? I don't mind that. I don't mind that. And this over here, let's make sure you have a main road connection. Or you know what? You can probably go down this way. It's faster to go down that way. And it'll keep this area clear. What we could do maybe is... Let's see if we can fit this in here. Oh, yeah, we can. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Cool. The reason why I want to do that is because... you know, let's go ahead and get rid of the footpath over here. Not only do I think it looks better, but now if you are leaving these garages and you need to go up, you go up that way. If you go down, you go down this way. It's like an actual city. Who'd have thunk? Who'd have thunk? All right, suspend and you as well. Good stuff. Though we still do need, of course, the footpath connection back over here. Do that. Why are we doing this? Because we want to. Because we want to. And of course, some trees. Why not? You can always use trees, right? Very cool. Very cool. Let's put some trees down over here as well again. It'll be needed to filter out some of the pollution eventually anyway. All right, good stuff. Good stuff. The schools and kindergartens are being done. I'm not going to complain about that because these guys will eventually need, yep. I mean, they already need schools and kindergartens, honestly. Look how interconnected everything is, though. That's crazy. I'm glad they increased the walking distances. It used to be, I think, 250 meters. but that has been increased rather greatly, it seems. Fantastic. Night falls once more. No prefab panels down here because our trucks are hopefully coming to pick them up, right? Do I need another train bringing prefab panels down? Because it's starting to feel like it. Starting to feel like it. Now look how far we have to pan just to get to our factory. We're topped up over here. Every time the train comes through... Excuse me, why didn't you... Hold on. Why didn't you load prefab panels? Why did you not load prefab panels? That doesn't make sense. Oh, because you're carrying boards. Oh, no! Right. You're carrying boards because this is topped up on boards. Huh. And you're carrying boards because the place where you're supposed to drop them off is topped up on boards. Where are we? There we go. Right. Okay. That's a problem. Looks like we do have a jam here after all. Alright, so hold on. Let's go ahead and hit play. How did you manage to do this? Despite having two crossings, how did you manage to do that? Are you moving or are you... There we go. I was waiting to clear the block. Oh, this is all jammed up, eh? Where are you? Are we going to the steel mill? Wow, these are remnants from a long time ago. I just realized these are from back when, like, bricks and steel weren't being produced enough to load entirely. That's hilarious. What's not so funny is the situation here. Because we have so many sources of boards. Alright, where's our steel train? You can load how many boards? 150 tons. 150 tons of boards. Which should empty this out. Alright, let me keep my eye on this train for a bit. Stuck here because you're waiting for that. No, okay, you're coming through. I just want to see if it actually loads up. Oh, right, it has a 50-50 split, of course, because bricks and boards go on the same type of bed. Still, that should empty up enough room for... Well, the problem is that there's all these other trucks that bring boards as well, right? My god. They just keep coming, don't they? Just never ends. It just never ends. By the time the train is back to drop boards off, this place is already filled up. We're a little too efficient, maybe. Maybe I should shut down the boards industry up over here. Okay, finally emptying out a little bit, but by the time the train comes back... Oh no, here it is. Okay, good. Good. So you're here, you're loading up on gravel first. And we should be able to come over here and drop off the boards, right? Come on now, drop them off. Alright, there we go. Good. Good. Good stuff. Problem solved. Solving some serious problems today, actually. This was a big problem solve as well. These tracks. Well, I say that, but as I say that, we obviously have a jam over here. Because why wouldn't we? Well, no, actually, I think it's once this pulls away, we'll be fine. Yeah, wow. Done. Folks, this is what we're gonna call it, a session. I hope you enjoyed this one. I hope you didn't get bored, eh? Because of the boards? Oh, God. Hope you enjoyed this session, though. If you did, you know what to do. Let me know by leaving a like and a comment down below. It makes a massive difference, like I always say, to how I approach content on the channel. I do read through all the comments as well to get an understanding of what y'all would like to see more or less of and how you'd like to see it produced and developed. And wow, this is wild. This is just absolutely wild. I'm so happy with the results of the fruits of our labor, as it were. Folks, as always, a massive thanks goes out to all of my channel members and patrons for supporting the channel on a monthly basis. You keep us alive and running smoothly. And a big old thanks goes out to each and every one of you for watching. Until next time, До свидания.